local nurses group questions the Commission on Higher Education's decision to lift the moratorium that prohibited colleges and universities from offering nursing programs. The Filipino Nurses United says there is no basis for such a move. The group believes the country has more than enough nursing graduates.
It's up to the government on how to entice these graduates to remain in service in the country. And that should be through offering higher wages, living wages, and of course, guaranteed security of tenure and timely releases of their benefits. We have plenty of graduates. Actually, as of June this year, we already have around 935,000 produced registered nurses. And of that number, 316,405 nurses are working outside of the Philippines as migrant workers.
The World Health Organization expecting to see repeated waves of COVID infections. The WHO cites how subvariants are being found to be more transmissible than the older strains. The agency adds confirmed cases of sublineages have been increasing despite a notable decline in surveillance, which it also notes should not be happening. The WHO continues to appeal to health officials to increase not only vaccination rates, but also improve early diagnosis and clinical care. An infectious diseases expert stands by his proposal to use the Dengvaxia vaccine amid rising dengue cases in the Philippines. Dr. Edsel Salvagna says the jab works if used properly. Dengvaxia was shelved after its manufacturer Sanofi warned Dengvaxia can trigger a more serious infection if given to those who have not been infected.
From a science perspective, it's very clear that if we use Dengvaxia properly in people who have had at least one bout of dengue, it does decrease your risk of severe disease by a lot. And we also have the tools now where we can actually check for dengue infection or prior dengue infection in someone before they get the vaccine. So, you know, that'll decrease the risk of having severe disease as a result of injecting somebody who has not had dengue.
So Philippine government agencies meet to tackle transport woes as a new school year begins next month. The Transportation Department says the meeting on Friday yielded recommendations, which include reinstating pre-pandemic city bus routes near and along the University Belt in Manila. The agency also eyes putting up bike racks to promote active transport for students traveling short distances. The OTR chief, Jaime Bautista, says he will also meet with transport groups in the coming days.
President Marcos urged to focus on soaring prices of basic commodities in his first State of the Nation address. Members of urban poor group Kadamay slams the government for delays in addressing the country's economic woes, including high prices of food and soaring fuel prices. Marcos is set to deliver his first SONA later this month.
Unang-una, kailangang mabilis niyang sagutin ang pagpapababa ng presyo o price control ng ating mga produkto, no? Mga presyo ng produkto. Kailangan ng tuloy-tuloy na ayuda. Kailangan na magkaroon ng sapat na ayuda para sa mamamayan dahil alam natin tumitindi ang bilang nakawala ng mga manggagawa na walang trabaho.